Okay, for the next point is improvement of working environment and working and work to become conducive to safety and health. Okay, how are we going to improve the environment? Okay, the first step is to create a plan to promote workplace health and safety. Okay, firstly, as a role of engineer, we can develop a safety plan. With this safety plan, we must ensure and we must give a briefing to our workers about what will we as an engineer do for their safety and what the workers must do for also for their to ensure their safety. Okay, with this kind of connection, we can ensure that the plan that we are provided will be the plan that we are provided can be do by the workers. Okay, the next one is to provide safety precaution steps and procedure. Okay, if as an engineer, if we don't provide the safety precaution steps and procedure, is one of the biggest fault to ensure the safety and health in a working place. Because as workers, some of the workers know and some of the workers don't know what the precaution and what the step if there are any hazard or there are any incident happen. So with this kind of precaution and steps, they will know what they must do to ensure the safety when they are working and to ensure their safety. So to ensure their safety when they are working. Okay, the next one is to train your workers and employees. Okay, with this kind of step, we must give a when we have give the guide. So the next thing we're gonna do is to provide a training, because when we provide the guide, we must also provide the training to give the understanding to the workers how they're gonna apply the guide and the procedure that we have given. Because especially if there a risk of potential injury associated with a job. Okay, so when the workers have given the training, they will know and they will much they will have better understanding with that kind of situation. Okay, next step is talk regularly with the worker or employees about the safety issues and safety and health issues that are occur in the working place. Okay, sometimes workers are not very good at listening, and that's why we must talk regularly. Because for example, when we as a child and our parents want us to do something good, right? Such as wash our dishes and throw our rubbish in the bin, they will talk about it regularly. So it's just also like a training in a real place, in a real life. So and there will be cost if we don't do what our parents said, right? For example, our pocket money will be cut and we cannot get what we want in the future. So this is one of the technique that we use to make sure all the employees are alert with the situation in the working place. Okay, for the conclusion that we have is, as a role of engineer, to ensure the safety and health in a certain organization or a certain workplace is by develop of work organization and working culture. Individual role as engineer is also important to ensure the safety and health in a working place. And the third one is to maintain the maintenance and promotion of workers' health and working capacity. And lastly, improvement of working environment and work to become conducive to safety and health. Okay, all of these points is really crucial and is really important, because if we don't do our role in as an engineer, this is our role. Okay, if we don't do, it will cost many things. It will cost money, it will cost time, it will cost work, it will cost energy, and the most important thing, it will cost a life. So I think life is more worth than any other thing. So I think that's all. Thank you.